Hey everybody, Mike Gant with Model Airplane News and Electric Flight, and today we got to play with the Seagull Glasair. And Seagull, you know, is part of Horizon Hobby, who puts out a lot of good planes. This one's no different. I noticed that it came from one of their factories over in Asia where some of the better planes are made, and this one really rivals those. It's a good quality balsa and ply structure. It's covered in their Hangar 9 Ultra Coat, and obviously you can see the taxi scheme. I think it's really cool, and it goes together very well. Wings slide on a couple of aluminum tubes in here, a couple of screws anchor those along with our struts down below to keep them in place. The motor went right on. There's a kit for that, mounts and blind nuts, very simple. Everybody's done that, I'm sure, before. And the linkages go really easily in. They're all phenolic control horns, metal rods, adjustable clevises. And all in all, it went together very quickly, so I was really happy with that. One last thing I'll point out is the pocket hinging that's done on it, and it's really neat the way they've done that, and it provides a clean look, and I think it lets a lot less air slip through that system there during flight. So take a look at this plane, you'll really enjoy it.
It's pretty cool looking.
I thought it was really cool looking, and everybody else says, it looks like a taxi.
It does.
That's all right, fair enough.
Inside the Glasair, I put a Sato FA-115 that's on the nose. It goes onto those little mounts like I described, very simply. Blind nuts, measure mark, drill it in place, some bolts. Very simple, measures out perfectly under the in front of the cowl, provide easy distance for the spinner back plate. We ran a couple different props, an Evolution 15-6, which does well, and then we tried a wood prop just now just to see, and it runs well also. Inside, we've got the AR-8000 Spectrum receiver, which runs about 7 servos because I've got the nose wheel, the rudder, flaps, ailerons, and of course the tail feathers and a throttle. So those are all Spectrum as well, and they do their job well. I put a little bit heavier of a unit, a 60-60, on the elevator here. It's quite a big piece of deviating flight element, if you will. And other than that, a battery, 5-cell, powers everything up. It's lasted quite a few flights. We're doing good with that. And a couple of 18-inch extensions I ran on each side of the wing, so when I take it apart, I can easily just jam those together, safety clip them, and I don't have to worry about fishing wires at all. So it makes it a quick and easy assembly at the field. As far as flight performance, this plane, it looks like a, you know, basic high wing trainer, and it almost flies like that, except it's a lot more sporty. You've got some good control throw available, the flaps to help you slow down, the tips on the ends help slow it down a little bit. It glides very well, and it does a lot of maneuvers. I mean, you'll easily pull vertical, you can do inside outside loops all day, inverted flight, knife edge flight. We even got it to do some stall type maneuvers. So this thing will do quite a bit, and taking off very easy, just jam the throttle and up it goes. Landings, you guys know me on those, I'm not the best, but I was able to get this thing down in one piece instead of one pieces, which is a good thing. And overall, I think intermediate to advanced pilots are really gonna enjoy this plane.